So, first stream. Yay. Fantastic. I'm excited. I just want to start streaming today what I'm working on, which is the Black Mage quilt. It's a new design that I'm doing with my friend Nicole. Nicole actually designed the Black Mage quilt. So before we can actually put it out to you...
Fantastic. I'm excited.
There we go. Sorry. before I can put the pattern out to you, it has to go through a couple steps. So the first step was that she did the actual design. Step two is I take the design and I figure out all of the fabric requirements, the pieces, things like that. Step three is I make it. So I actually have to make the quilt from scratch with everything to make sure that all of the requirements are correct. And then after that, then I write it all out, I figure it out, then I send it back to Nicole, and she then takes all of the measurements and the instructions and everything that I've given her, and she puts it into a nice, pretty presentation for you. Then, of course, it gets proofread and all sorts of stuff, and then we actually can send it off to the printer. So lots of steps. So this is step three. I'm actually making the Black Mage quilt that Nicole has designed. So that's what I'm going to be working on for the next couple hours. You may see behind me, I have a bunch of pieces laid out. I have it laid out this way, that way I can just reach back and grab them. And the only thing I do not like about my setup with the cameras is you can't see the ironing board. But I may get a third camera in here so you can do that. You also can't see my pretty desk, my nice sewing table that I'm using. All right, pins. There. Got that. Great. And let's do... Perfect. That is exactly what I want. Okay. Look at that. I was just adjusting some of the settings. Because this is my first stream, I get to go through and play with all the settings over and over. All right, so there, that one goes this way. I've got that. Great, got that. Okay, so this one. For those of you just joining me, I am making the Black Mage quilt for our new pattern. Behind me, I have all the pieces laid out, and the pattern is actually to the left of the table. Oh, hey, Doug, how are you? I like your Twitter handle. It's very easy to tell that that's you. Let me just sew these. So my goal tonight is to hopefully get this top finished. Because we want to try to get this pattern out soon. We haven't released a pattern since November. So I'm a little behind on the schedule. Completely my fault, not Nicole's. So I'm hoping to get this done tonight so I can get all of the notations and the pattern and everything to her tomorrow. And what I'm doing right now is chaining. So the nice thing about chaining is it's super fast and efficient and allows me to sew a whole bunch of those quilt pieces all at the same time. So how does the sound sound? How is the sound, Doug? Can you hear me pretty good? It appears the layout table camera is frozen. I'm assuming it's supposed to be. Oh, no. See, look. Oh, no, you're right. That is frozen. Thanks. All right, let's get that fixed. I have a problem with that camera sometimes. So let's do the properties, deactivate, and activate. And there it goes. Great. Yeah, there's something about that camera that freezes. So if I don't actually be on camera for a bit, the feed itself freezes. And I sure enough did. Dang it, I forgot to take out the ones I did. So these are the next two. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, let me look at my pattern. And brown, brown. So brown, brown, right there. Okay, and then the brown, there, okay, there's that one. Chat is, chat's not appearing on Twitch, okay, so, wonder why that is, let me check. Oh, probably because I minimized it. Okay, so let me do that. And window capture, properties, there we go. How is that? So I will let you know. Okay, fantastic. All right, let's go that way. 1, 2. Great. And could you see the perfect pop-up on the feed on the TV? Have to get used to this delay between the video and chat. Okay, great. Thanks, Doug. I appreciate that. love my new chair. It is, it was part of the Aero package that I got with the table, the two things this way, yes. My thread things, which I absolutely love. And I got two of these chairs. So my plan is to have guests so people can come over and do some sewing with me, and they have another chair, and maybe that's how we do the two cameras. I don't know. Just some ideas. Maybe get some local cosplayers. My friend Megan from Absinthetica said that she's up for some sewing, so that'll be fun. There we go. Great. I set my iPad over there, that way I can see the chat in case you have any questions while I'm pinning. Everything I do is based upon nesting seams. So if you have any of my patterns, nesting seams is super important, and I actually tell you which way to iron all of your seams. Okay, so this one. Nope, it's not going to work on there. Oh well. Is the second one, so it goes that way to the left. Yep, seems the left. Alright, so I'm going to have to close this and just have to glance back at the chat on there. So Nicole and I had our meeting a couple of weeks ago with our planning for the entire year. So we planned out all of our patterns. Black Mage was actually supposed to be the pattern after the next one, but we had to work on the next one a little bit, so I bumped this one up. I've been asked a few times why I keep my nails so thick. This is why. I use them to stop the pins. It is not a good habit to be in, but it's something I do. Four is to the left. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pieces. So we're going to skip that one. So Doug, some of you heard me talking to Doug, who's in the chat typing a little bit. He is one of my favorite minions, and he's actually going to be able to join us at New York Comic Con this year, so I'm super excited. So for those of you that saw me at New Orleans, St. Louis, I think those are the only two recently that Doug's done with me. He was my minion there, the big guy that towers above me. He's my muscle. This way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The reason why I'm doing this is whenever you're sewing pieces together, it's always better to sew the smaller pieces. So in this case, I have an odd number that I'm going to be actually sewing. So I'm going to take the longer piece, which is in the front, and set it aside. Okay, back to sewing. You know I love you, Doug. If only your wife would want to travel and be a part of it as much as you do. That'd be fun. Oh, you know what I did? No, I didn't. Okay, good. All right. I did. I messed it all up. Okay. I did. I do that. Oh man, I forgot the first row I had already done, so these are all off. Okay, so back to this one. This one is now. I do that, hence my nice sign here, a person who doesn't make mistakes. All right. This is the top one, so it goes this way to the right. To the right. To the right. It's easy to fix though. Right. No. Yes. Nope, to the left. Okay, to the left. All right. And then this one. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that's it. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, no, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's what I get for talking and sewing at the same time. 2, yeah. Yeah, you know how often I have sewn through things and gotten to the end? And everything's messed up. One of my first quilts was the Alliance symbol, and I was so proud of that. It was a king-size quilt. It was pretty darn cool. And I finished the whole thing, and I hung it up to take the picture, and the piece in the bottom right is upside down. At this point, I've quilted it. I've done everything. I forgot to do my double checks. And yeah, needless to say, I was not very happy with that. So let's redo this one. So if you actually go to my Quiltoni page, you can see the mistakes there. All right, so that one is down here. Okay, this one goes there to the right. Okay, that's to the right. Yeah, if you go to my Quiltoni page and look at the Alliance quilt, you can see in the bottom right the mistake I made. Right, right, okay, got that one, and then this one, and then this one, and there, and then this one. Great, that's it. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Because of these mistakes, that's why I have all these double checks in place. So when I sat down at the sewing machine, I was double checking what I was working on. Because of that, I found my mistake. Yeah, invest in a good seam ripper if you're a sewer. They are, yeah, essential. Okay, now this one is, okay, there's that way. Nope, that is this one now. Okay, so here's there. Okay, we're going to the left. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So it's this one to the left. And notice I'm taking my seams and I'm pointing them to the left because that is the way that this row has to do. And when I get to assembling rows, you'll see why. All right, so this one goes that way. And then there. Okay, so 1, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're all to the right. To the right. So these are to the right. Yes. There. There. To the right. To the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So normally I have the TV on and I watch Hulu or Netflix or something else. I try to watch programs that are don't take much thought. I can kind of just listen to them. I don't actually have to watch them. But of course, during the stream, if I'm going to be talking, I don't want anything in the background. I noticed some other creative streamers play some music, and I was thinking about that, but I decided what kind of music I want yet. This is the second one. So there. One, two, three, four. Okay, so here is that one. There's one, two that goes over here. Okay, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. is my seam ripper. This is one of the most amazing seam rippers. It's from Seam Fix. So not only is it the seam ripper, which is pretty cool, but this little rubber end actually helps you get all of the pieces out. And you'll see what I mean. Okay, so one, two, three. See what I did. And no, actually, this one's pretty good. Nope. Yeah, this one's good. Fantastic. So it's everything else would have been messed up, but that one I don't have to seam rip. Two, three. Great. Okay. So one, two, three, four, and I already did five, six. Found an Empire logo, queen size. No, not the Empire. The, you're funny, Doug. No, the Alliance, Warcraft Alliance. It looks like the lion. So it's a blue background with a yellow crest. And if you look in the bottom right, you'll see a single piece upside down. Very annoying. So, needless to say, my husband sleeps with that quilt now. I can't sell a quilt that has a mistake like that. I like these wheels. This is great. I have carpet, and they roll quite nicely on the carpet. I was thinking about getting one of those plastic mats. This works fine. It's okay to have Star Wars on the brain. I always have Star Trek and Star Wars on the brain. Did you see on my Quiltoni Facebook the meme I put up yesterday for Star Trek? I know, baby boy. I know. I'm not giving you anything. You already eat dinner. Yeah. To make it so. I thought it was funny, but apparently there's a lot of people that like the one today better. Yeah. But I'm a Star Trek person. Star Trek and Star Wars. One, two, three. Here. So, to prevent making that mistake again, I am going to pin them as I iron them. One, two, three. Now notice this one is three pieces. So I'm going to pin it all together for efficiency. And that's one of the reasons why you don't have the long pieces continue to stay long, and you want to keep those out if you have an odd number. Three. And this one I dropped, so to make sure it's good. There. There. And there. Yes. Okay, so one, two, three. For those that haven't bought any of my patterns, I actually, in my patterns, tell you how to lay all these pieces out. I am doing rows, the bottom six rows right now for the new pattern. And I tell you which way to iron the seams. Oops, that's not right. I ironed my seam the wrong way. There we are, flip it. Three to the right. Hold on. Yep, that one belongs down here. Really, Marley? So we have three dogs and a cat, which is why it's super important I keep this right here, so if I see any hair, I can roll it right off, so I don't have any dander or hair on any of the fabric as I'm going. And yeah, one of my dogs is bothering the cat. All right, right. I know, baby girl. You can always brush her. I know, Marley. Yeah, come here. Come here, Marley. Come here. Oh, let's show them what you look like. Say hi. Yeah, this is his, oh my god, you're going to kill me in my sleep look, because he doesn't like being picked up. All right, go bother the cat. Now all the pieces are good. Okay, that's good. That's good. Now my next pass through, I will sew together the ones that need yet another pinning. So this one has two pieces, so I have to sew that one again. This one has one piece, so I will skip it. This one in my hands now. I have two pieces, so I'll sew it. Just the fastest, most efficient way of doing it. two, three, four to the left. Marley, leave her be. Now, making sure you notice some of these, I put three pins in, some I put two in. If they have a seam in the center, that's when I put three pins in. Because I want to make sure that my seams do not get sewn all zigzag and wonky, that they get sewn flat. So that allows them to be sewn flat. Okay, so this one needs to be sewn. So this one is the sixth to the left. Oh, no, this one was up here. And then these two are going to get sewn together. So I sew them as a set. Oops. My video is choppy. All right. Nope, it's fine. It was just a bad upload. Okay, 1, 2, 3 to the right. 1, 2, 3, yep, that's right. So my goal is to stream, if not at least once a day, every other day, because there's going to be gaps when I'm at conventions that I can't stream. I've been toying with the idea of possibly streaming while we're doing setup at conventions. That way you can see what goes into it, how we build our structures, design them, lay them out. Oh, you know what I forgot? Oh, you found the Alliance issue. Wonder why the video is so choppy. All right, I think I've got it now. Okay. Yeah, it's not even the time lapse. It's the upload, download, things like that. I know that there is a setting where I can skip the time lapse, so it's more, I can see the chat, you know, more, I can see it sooner. But then the problem with that is that the upload speed is worse. Marley! Hey! Shush! Shush, mister! Alright, so, now I've got these two sewn. So I've got my first row. So that is the first row on the bottom. Oops, nope. I sewed that one the wrong way. Not sewed it, I'm sorry, ironed it the wrong way. I mumble to myself a lot too. All right, now what I'm doing now is another check. I'm double checking to make sure the row is exactly how I wanted it. And that row is exactly how I wanted it. And then I'm gonna sew my rows. So at this point, I'm not actually going to sew this row. I'm just gonna pin it together. And then just to the left of my ironing board, I have a rack, a drying rack, that I lay all of my rows out on. Hold on, that's not right. Did I just iron that all completely wrong? I did, didn't I? Did. That's all supposed to go to the left. And I ironed some of them to the right. That is an easy fix. You can just re-iron it. It's important the seams go in the correct direction because when you nest them, when you lay them up against each other, it is going to be a perfect sewn fit, just like this. See how that's perfectly in there like that. And that's because you iron them in opposite ways. This is all ironed this way, and now that's all ironed that way. Now, I should fit it. There it goes. Rows are pinned together. So I'm just gonna lay this over here. I move that closer. Okay, so I'm gonna lay that right there. So there's the first two rows. Next. Convention setup time lapse video. I think we could, yeah, see, that's what I was thinking. Not just in New York too though. I've got my C2E2 setup's a really big one, like New York. I mean, it's because really all I need is a really good internet and my computer and my cameras. So it's totally doable. But honestly, it's all going to be up to the people that I'm with. Because I don't ever want to put anyone on camera that's not comfortable being on camera. So whenever, if I make that happen, if we do a convention set up, I'll make sure that I announce it way ahead of time. And then what I'm planning on doing for these videos after the stream is live, I'm planning on moving it all over to YouTube. So it actually has all of my videos backlogged there. So you can go back and rewatch stuff. So the convention ones, I'll then probably put into a super time lapse. Alright, so I've done rows 1 and 2. I need to get another sheet of paper. Nope, I'll use that one. I'll use the one woman pattern. Okay, so let's move that up. And 1, 2. Okay, so this is 3, 4. So this is to the right. That all looks good. And this is all to the left. That one looks good. Okay. So let's pick this one. So far, so good. I don't actually have to finish this entire top tonight. I just have to assemble all the rows, but of course, depending upon the time, I may just continue on so you can watch me finish the entire thing. But the biggest thing is making sure that I have my count of how many pieces to cut out correct, and I have my fabric count correct. Because there's nothing worse than buying a quilt pattern and having a mistake in it. Whenever I first started learning to quilt, there were so many quilt patterns that I would get that had small little mistakes because they didn't have publishers or proofreaders or things like that. And then you get some really amazing patterns by amazing people like Lorna McMahon, who is So Fresh Quilts. She's actually here in Ontario. She has, I don't know who proofreads her patterns, but She's able to spit them out really fast, and she does an amazing job. If you look at the So Fresh Quilts Etsy page, she does all sorts of animals and creatures, and yeah, her stuff is amazing. So, even though I said I wasn't going to sew together the rows, this is chain piecing, constant sewing of everything. So I've taken the first two rows that are pinned together, and I'm going to sew it. Now I'm not pulling behind my machine, I'm just guiding. I'm just making sure it's going in at a straight angle. There we go. All right, this one. This one. Oh, look at that. I forgot to sew one of my edges. So, guess what? I'm going to be sewing another row. Okay. All right. Here's that one. And here's rows 3 and 4. All right, let's make sure. 1, 2, that's all sewn. 3, 4, that's all sewn. Now I know you can't see my rack, it's just to my right, but whenever I put the ones that I just finished sewing over there, rows 5 and 6, whenever I pin them together, I'm gonna make sure that they go on the rack with a space between that and rows 1 and 2. Because if I don't have a space there, I may forget the order of this one. So I've got that, because this is 5 and 6, and I don't want 5 and 6 to get out of order with 3 and 4. Now, depending upon your sewing setup at home, if you do this method, you may have a large enough space to all lay them out so you can constantly see it, or you may have a design wall. And I have a design wall, but I do all my rows like this, and it's hard for them to stick on the design wall because they're too heavy. 2. I'll make sure to share my design wall when I do, oh, look what I did. That's not the way it's supposed to be. Okay, seam ripper. All right, you get to see this baby in action. So this goes that way. Okay, that's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's wrong. Okay. Okay. This piece right here. Baby boy. A Shoko boy? You're never this active. Are you active because I'm filming? And again, that's why I do the double check. So, I've used my seam ripper. Now I'm going to take the top and just pull the threads right out. Just like that. And I've got to re-iron this one. For those of you that have traditional seam rippers, you know how nice that is. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. It goes right here. Marley, no. Soleil, no. Hey, leave the cat alone. The cat doesn't want to play with you. Gosh. the nice thing about this is most of the time it stays just like on the top. So you can just grab it and toss it in the trash. Okay, let me open this. All right, so that one is good. This one goes here to the left there. And now I don't want to get behind. I want my super efficiency to the left. So I'm actually going to set this aside and lay out the next two rows and pin them so that I can sew them up in between. Okay, so this one. Okay, so let me get this in the machine. Out. Okay. Yeah, at least I don't have to worry about that space. Okay, so the next two. So let's put this up. Actually, I'm going to lay them out down there. All right, so I need blue black towards the black. I need a blue. I need a blue black. That's up towards the blue, so the next one's towards that blue. Down. Black. Yellow. I only have one of those pieces. Marley, no. There. Cat's just glaring at him. And there, there. And there, here. It's just one. Black. Black. Brown, and then towards the background, past it and pin. As I'm pinning these, I always glance over at my pattern just to make sure they are correct. Never be too careful. As you've seen, I've already made a few mistakes. Next row. Towards the blue, so the next one's towards the blue. And whenever I'm mumbling to myself about this, that is the direction of the seams. Towards the blue. Yellow. And you know I'm getting to a nice part in my pattern when I start running out of colors over here. And there. Okay. No, that's wrong. Nope, it's not. Okay, there, there. I was thinking it was a small piece. Good. Okay. And I don't think I said it before. I actually pin it this way because then whenever I sew it, that's also the way that I'm going to iron it with my seams. So it's saves it so I don't have to keep double checking the pattern. Once I've got it laid out, I know this is the way it is. Again, about efficiency. You may notice I keep looking over and checking my pattern. I'm double checking the way that the seams have to be ironed because I have the worst memory, and sometimes if I don't check it, I'll forget which way I'm going, and I'll grab it wrong. Marley! No, the cat doesn't want to play with you. All right. Oh, you only make mistakes if people don't get suspicious? Yeah, I make mistakes because I make mistakes. There's only a couple of viewers. Doug, what do you think of the camera angles? Do you like the way that I've got it laid out for the sewing machine and the cutting table? Marley, you can go upstairs. Alfred's up there. Awesome. Thanks. I've been playing around with it for a couple of days, trying to figure out the best way that you can actually see the chaining on the machine, and you can see the pinning and the piecing on the mat. Like I said, I may add a third one, but I don't know. I kind of like having the chat show up in the view. All right, now we can do these rows. Okay, that looks much better, and that is the way it's supposed to be. That's tomorrow night, I have one of my friends, Monica, coming over to do a little sewing. She is, she's mostly a scrapbooker. She does lots of scrapbook stuff, and she hasn't sewn in forever. So I don't know if she's going to bring any of her sewing things and just borrow one of my machines, or if she's going to bring any of her scrapbook stuff to work on. So I'll probably try to have a camera on what she's working on and a camera on what I'm working on. Or she may just come to talk with me and drink some wine while I sew. Alright, so we've got that. Okay, so this is our first row now. This is our second row. And we move these up because they're done. Great. Alright, row three. Got it towards the black. I put those up there. Okay. Towards the black. Yellow. Nope, that's the gold piece. That's right. I'm now in his hat. So that's a gold piece. On the pattern that I have here, it's a little hard to tell the gold from the yellow. So I think that is one change that we'll have to do, is make the yellow maybe a little bit lighter and the gold a little bit darker, just so you can tell the difference. Okay, there. Black. Two. Background. This is the single background piece that's in within there. And staff. Down. Two. And then towards the black. And then a single background. Okay, let's double check it. There, there, there. Two. Okay, I've got the black on the side. Great, fantastic. Oh! I did do that, didn't I? If you're wondering why I have them in groups of two, those are the pieces I pinned together. Well, see, I don't know. Huh. I see what you mean. Let me see. Let me pick this up and move it that way. Yeah, you still won't be able to see me iron. Let's shift this over. Let me do that. So you can still see that a little bit better. I've got that. Yeah, you may be able to see it a little bit then. Yeah, because the iron is all the way over there. So, all right. Let's go back there to the feed. Yeah, so I don't know if that'll work. Moving the sewing machine so you can see me iron. I think if, to see me iron, I probably just have to get a third camera. Ah! watching my dogs play. Get him, Slade! Get him! Go with it, get him! Get him! Soleil, come here, baby. Do it. Come on, up. Up. Soleil, you can't go that way. Come on, up. Up. Come on, up. Now, this is Soleil. I knew you good girl, ain't ya? She's playing with Marley. I know, Marley. You're a good boy, aren't ya? Always keep people that are allergic to pets in mind when you're doing the sewing for other people. Because that's the biggest thing, right? I don't know who's going to buy my quilts. They could have a dog allergy. So anytime I touch the dogs, anytime I see any stray hairs, anything at all, always clean it up. Make sure they stay away from the actual machines and thread, which is why I have these lovely pullouts to hide all my thread. So it is to background there. Okay, that's towards the black, so it's going to go towards the black, and I've got to iron this because I only have towards the black, so I've got to iron it towards the blue. Hey, guys, stop. Marley, no. Leave the cat alone. The funniest thing is the cat is deaf. So she can't hear anything that the dogs are doing barking at her. Marley! He is a happy dog. And towards the brown. So I need two towards the brown. So I need to iron one. Okay. So I will switch them. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more rows. 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I'll do 2 more and then I'll have 3 to go. Okay, here. Yeah, this is the boring part. Laying it all out. Okay, so I need towards the yellow. Having problems going in yellow. Yellow. Okay, I did it towards the yellow, so I need to go towards. Oh, let me grab the other one. Towards the black, that we don't have to re-iron. Towards the black. And that's my last blue piece. Black. Background. Towards the brown. No, reverse that. Now I don't have to re-iron. Go towards the black. Towards the black. Reverse the black. Towards the brown. Towards the brown. And then towards the background. Okay. Another thing I do when I lay pieces out is sometimes I'll flip them and turn them upside down. Yeah. And I'll just do one more row after this. Oh, I am doing fine. How are you? I have the chat behind me, so when I'm working here at all of the pinning, I can't read the chat. This is the next quilt pattern design, the Black Mage, that I'm working on. Yeah, I just need to keep reminding myself to turn around every now and then and glance at the chat. I actually had a super long day today. My parents were visiting from the States to see my stepdaughter play ringette. So we drove 2 hours to go to a ringette game this morning, had lunch with them, and then they headed back off to the States. We came home so I could stream. And I'm still going to the right. Finish that one off. All right, and then the last one for this set. That one. Towards the background, towards the gold. Big piece of gold. Little piece of gold. Last piece of black. So far, my count is pretty good. Okay, now am I gonna have to use that piece for, no, okay. I was checking to make sure I didn't have to use one of these to go left or right for anything because I only have two pieces left and I would like to avoid re-ironing if possible. And there. Okay. Oh, I have
some really cool news. Arrow Sewing, Arrow Furniture, the furniture I wrote my blog about, that all new furniture for my sewing room that I got, the lovely chair, my desk, these, my thread holders, everything, they are going to be giving away a chair to one of my fans. So one of these fantastic, awesome chairs, I love these things, they're going to be giving one away. So we don't have any details, we don't have anything yet, although I'm thinking we may do something while I'm in Vegas, because I'm going to see them there. They're going to be in Vegas. So we may do Facebook Live. So if you don't like my Facebook page, if you want to try to win a free chair, you may want to do that. So when I'm there, we can actually go set up the contest. And that's going to be in 2 weeks? No, a week and a half. Wow. It's going to be that. Yeah, so almost 2 weeks. No, actually 2 weeks from today is the first day of that. Is the first day of the sewing trade show that I will be at. So, but you do, of course, don't have to be in Vegas to win. You can be anywhere in North America to win. All right, so I've got that. I've got that. Okay, time to sew. So I'm super excited about giving away a chair. And for those that just joined, this is chaining. You probably hear me talk about how I can finish quilts quickly because I chain. That's what I'm doing. So I actually have 12 sewing machines. One is an embroidery machine, one is the scan and cut, and the rest are just regular sewing machines. The reason why I have that many is I have one that I use for all of my actual quilting, for combining everything together, and I have a whole bunch of these. These are the Brother CS6000. They're cheap little, of course, all my machines are Brother, because I love Brother. They're super easy to use with the drop-in bobbins and everything. They are, the CS6000s are cheap machines, but they're lightweight, easy to transport. They break easily, which is why I have 8 of them. So if one goes down, I can just grab another one. And a lot of times, if they break, I don't repair them. I just buy another one because they're cheaper to replace than they are to repair. But the reason why I have so many is I actually try to take machines with me and teach classes. I've been teaching classes here in London, Ontario, at the Family Center. I actually have a meeting there tomorrow where we're going to be planning our next couple of classes and then teaching. And a lot of the
people that go to the family center want to learn how to sew, but they don't have a sewing machine. So I bring my bank of machines with me. Although the next set of classes, I think we're going to leave it open. If you have a machine, you can bring yours with you. You don't have to borrow one of mine. My mom bought me a cool thing from the Gypsy Quilter that allows you to just quickly cut all of the chained pieces. But those are for people that don't sew over their needles. What you see me doing here, that's a no-no. You're not supposed to sew over your needles You're not supposed to sew over your pins because your needle can break. And it does. It breaks a lot. Which is why I have a ton of them right here in the drawer. Alright. So first round. Now it's ironing time. I love my Aliso iron, because it allows me to iron quickly and then just set it aside. It's a little more expensive than a lot of other irons, but it saves me time, and for me, that is super important. Okay, so we're going to the right. Make sure that this is the correct one, and it is. So, to the right. Okay, this one's going to have an odd number. Okay, so this one's to the left. That's got an odd number, so I'm going to set that one there to include that last piece. She also has one that we can run on in, oh yeah. And yeah, no, it's such a bad habit to sew on your pins, but it's actually, I'm so anal retentive about a lot of things. I'm very, very particular. And my seams lining up perfectly is one of my very anal retentive things. And I have found if I pull out the pins as I sew, it can get a little wonky. I don't like it a little wonky. I like it perfect. Although it's not going to be perfect, but I can try. It is, I was talking to a lady at MagFest about mistakes, and I was sharing with her some advice that, one of my friends, the Quilt Skipper, she's amazing. If you look her up, Quilt Skipper, she is just, yeah, absolutely love her. Jenny Lyons. The advice that she gave me she actually taught me a lot of free motion quilting, and we were talking about making mistakes, and she said, you know what,
You are your own worst critic. If you sew something and you don't like it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have another 6, 7. If you sew something and you don't like it, take a few steps back. Move at least 3 feet away from your quilt or whatever you have sewn and look at it. If you can't see what you don't like, then no one else is going to see it. And it's so true. And it's like that alliance quilt that I showed, that I was talking about earlier for those that just joined. I royally messed up one of my first quilts. The alliance crest from Warcraft. Nope. Look at that. I counted wrong. And I inverted one of the pieces. They're upside down. And of course, I didn't catch it until after I completely quilted the whole thing. But that's because it's a pixelated quilt. Oh, you can see it. And it's very noticeable. And actually, I didn't notice it until I was 3 feet back. So, yeah, that's one my husband sleeps with. But I do have the picture up on my website. But it's one of those, just sewing over the pins is one of those very anal retentive things that I would rather replace my needles and have my machines in the shop a little bit more often than not have perfect seams. There we go. See, at least when I do that, if I miscount, that's an easy fix. It's not like earlier when I royally messed it up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, another 7. Okay, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, so it's to the left. There. Oh, really? See, model railroading isn't something that I've done. It's always something that I've been interested in. But it's, I get very obsessive compulsive about things. Whenever I first learned how to quilt, I just immediately like, nope, this is it. This is what I'm doing. And I took off with it. And because of that, with hobbies, I'm very reluctant to start it because I'm afraid I'll get a little carried away. And model railroads is something that I'm afraid if I ever got into, I would get carried away with because it's so cool. So yeah, so it's the same thing. So I guess with the painting and the laying out and things like that, I guess you want to make sure it looks good, but at the same time, you don't want to be your own critic and be too hard on yourself. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I actually, when I was looking through the Creative Channel the other day, I actually saw someone painting miniatures for Model Railroads. It's actually, I was watching him for a little bit. It's pretty cool. I don't remember his name. I didn't subscribe to his channel, although I wish I would have. Hopefully I'll catch him again. Okay, and I believe this was a 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, 8. Okay, and that's to the right. This is why Laura jokes that she thinks I'm a robot, because I really can make a quilt start to finish in a day. And I normally do sit and talk to myself, so this really isn't that much different. There, okay, so we have everything ironed and pinned.
somehow my stitch length changed. For the CF6000s, the stitch length actually defaults to 2.5. I do not like 2.5. That is way too long. So I changed it to 1.6. Somehow it defaulted back. Oh, yeah. No, I hear you, Doug. I mean, things are so expensive with that stuff. Like, Mike, my husband, used to do the tabletop gaming with the little miniatures, Warhammer. And that stuff is so expensive. And as he was telling me the other day, as they would come out with new sets and new expansions, they would actually have you buy all new things and repaint all new things. And so it gets super, super expensive. Any hobby is expensive. This, even though it's a cheap machine, this machine is 160, 170, just for the machine. Fabric is ridiculously expensive. It's normally between $10 and $12 a yard for the good quilt store stuff, which is what I use now. So yeah, no, it's, hobbies in general are expensive. It's ridiculous. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So let's put that there and there. All right, so the first pass through is done. And I'll be on to the second pass through. And then after I get these rows done, I only have three more rows. And then I will take a look at the time, although I'm doing pretty good. It's only almost 7 o'clock. My goal is to get it finished by 8. If I can do that, then I can go play some Borderlands. You have to have some priorities, right? I've been replaying Borderlands 2 with a friend and my husband. And we want to try to play it tonight. So, I've set my goals, and if I do it... myself play. All right, look at that. No, it's, and I've seen some of these shows with the model train culture, and yeah, no, I can totally see how it's completely different beast. Okay, you see what it is? Kickstart. I told you, I'm tired today. I've had a long day. We had to drive 2 hours to go to Renekin. The only way I was going to do this was to give myself some energy. It'll go away soon, but right. Oh, I slept most of the day. Oh, really? You know what? It's because we're getting old. When we reach a certain age in our lives, our body tends to hurt. I tend to live on Advil and Tylenol right now, depending upon which part of my body hurts. Yeah, I wish I could have taken a nap and slept today, but I have work that has got to get done. If this pattern does not get finished and over to Nicole, she's gonna be mad at me because I'm putting this behind. The schedule is having this release on February the 8th. That's not happening. I still have to have it proofread. So once I get it over to Nicole, it'll take her a minimum of a week to probably get it all laid out and get the actual pattern made. And then I have to have someone proofread it. And that could take another couple of days. Okay, one, two, three, four. Looks good. And yes, I'm getting old. Two, three. Looks good there. Yeah, we definitely do not want to make Nicole mad. Especially because she's the one that said to bring you to New York, right? It's never good to have Nicole mad at you. Fantastic. No, I was just counting everything and making sure it is all good, and it is. So now it is time for ironing. All right. Four. In my head right now, I'm saying top, 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 top to remember that this goes on the top and not the bottom. I've done that one before too. Things we do, especially when we've been doing it for years and years. All right, so hopefully, when I start laying all these rows out, where I'm not going to have the same problem that I had the last time. Yeah, the only thing that you haven't seen today is actually cutting all the fabric out. I'll try to get that onto another stream I do. Three, four. Fantastic. That's too bright. Perfect.
when I was doing my layout of the cameras on the screen there, I was trying to decide if I wanted to have the chat on there or not. And I decided that, you know what? Yes, I want the chat on there because whenever I watch Twitch, I tend to watch it through the Roku, and the app on the Roku doesn't show the chat. It doesn't have the view that the computer does. Well, if someone is streaming and they're talking to a person from the chat, I can't see it unless they have it on their screen. So I decided that was probably the best way to go for people like me that when watching, watch it on their TV. And also, whenever I then transfer this to YouTube, so if anyone wants to go back and rewatch something that I've said or done, you know that I'm not talking to myself the entire time and answering my own questions. Although I do that sometimes. Alright, I think everything needs another pass. Yes. Okay. Does Lori hand sew at all? Or is she able to hand sew? Let her know that one of the patterns that we are coming out with is an English paper piecing Catan quilt. So I've been working on it and I'm actually going to be teaching it at Gen Con, but I'm going to be coming out with the pattern and the kit. So you don't have to be able to machine sew at all. If you can hand sew, then you can make it. Yeah, that's true. Anything that you do for cosplay, you're going to have custom. Did we feed the cat, Mike?
Yep.
Okay. Alright, so final pass. And the reason I fold the fabric over like that is it just makes it more manageable. I just reach up and pick it. Right. And he does car upholstery. Oh. Yeah, no, considering you live in Illinois, her living in Chicago, and her living in Georgia, that's not a, that's not conducive to using her machines. The machine I'm using right now, the CS6000, could not do leather work. Now my other one could, my Laura Ashley edition. But that's a really expensive machine. All right, this is the top one to the left. Would you do me a favor, hon? Would you, oh, never mind. I've got it. I was gonna ask you to fill this up with water, but I'm good. On your way up, would you fill this and just set it on the sink in the bathroom? And then when I run out, I'll go upstairs and grab it. You don't have to bring it back down. What? 8 o'clock? Yeah, it's fine. It's 7:09. Yes, I should get this done by 8. So yes, Borderlands, 8 o'clock. So that means I have 50 minutes to get this finished. Okay. All right, so I've already done the one. Here is two. Okay, three, four. All right, now comes the moment of truth. Let's see if I've got it. With 3 foot, yes, that's this area right here. So this is only, where is my regular one? So this throat is 6 inches. So if you have a 3 foot, that's really, really good. So it's the amount of stuff you can push through here. My Laura Ashley has got a 12-inch one, a 12-inch throat. So it's so much easier to get quilts through there, but it also has a much better motor. If you try to put leather or things like that through this machine, it'll kill it. Okay. All right. Moment of truth time. Okay. Okay, this one looks good so far. I didn't sew anything upside down. Okay, that's to the right. This is to the left. Nope, I think this one looks good too. Great. Okay, so the first two are done. Oh, also rotary cutting. It's fantastic for the abs. It's the only time I ever give my abs a nice workout. Yeah, but the biggest thing, Doug, is if you do want to get into cosplay and actually sewing your own costumes, do not buy a machine until you know that it can handle it. In the Illinois area, it is actually a huge Bernina area because Bernina has their headquarters in Illinois. So I think almost every single Bernina could handle it, but they're a little expensive. I would go in and take a look at them and see if that's something that you'd be interested in, and then keep an eye and see if they go on sale, they have any used, or even look in Craigslist or someplace like that, because they can always have used machines there. Okay, oh, I'll move it up in a minute. Marley! He's still trying to play with the deaf cat. The cat's just ignoring him. That's what I should do, is have a third camera facing the pets. You guys are very cute. Yes, and I know you're cute too. Next two. Okay. This is to the left. This one's to the right. Looks good. Fantastic. That's good. It's interesting, when I lived in Maryland before I moved up here, Nicole used to come over at least once a week, sometimes twice a week, and just to crochet at my house while I sewed. And I found that if I had someone to talk to and interact with, I actually didn't realize how much work I was getting done, and I became a lot more efficient. And actually, as I'm looking at the clock here, I'm finding that I'm actually doing this even a little faster than what I normally do, even with the mistake of having to rip everything out and redo that one row. And again, what I'm doing here is not only lining those seams up, but looking for any seams that need to get pinned down. So when I sew, I don't have to worry about them flipping up. And everything will be nice and lined up. There we go. She has an, okay, yeah. Oh yeah. No, you're absolutely right. Yeah, no, the Berninas are really expensive, but they're really nice machines and they last a long time. So that's something where if you can, not even afford it, but if you can find a good deal on one, I should say,
it may be one to look at. But if you don't like the feel of it, then there's no point even looking at them. So that's why I said, don't buy one, just stop in and play around. Because everyone has their own type of machine. I mean, you've got the Janome's, of course, I'm a brother girl. Singer. Baby Lock. Baby Lock's another good one. I believe somewhere south, like Tennessee, Kentucky, someplace I've wanted to lose their headquarters. I don't remember. But Baby Lock's are nice machines too. They're a lot like the Brothers. But if you decide to get a less expensive brand, like Brother is a less expensive brand, you have to be very careful the machine you get. Because like I said, these CS6000s are only about $175, but there's no way they could handle leather. You would kill that motor and it would break and you're wasting your money. The only thing I use this for is piecing and making pillowcases and dice bags. And that is it. I do not quilt on this. I do not put anything heavy in this. When I get to my streams where I'm actually quilting and binding, you'll see me use my Laura Ashley Edition machine. Technically, it's the Quilt Club, which is the precursor to the Laura Ashley. They only made the Quilt Club 1 year. And they actually tried to market it to quilters. I love the machine, so I bought it. But then they realized that quilters were not necessarily buying that machine, but home decorators, people that wanted to do their own curtains or upholstery or leather or things like that, would use the machine, but they didn't quite know if it could handle those things. So they actually rebranded it as the Laura Ashley, aiming it at interior decorators. So it can definitely handle all that stuff, but I don't remember. I know when I bought it years ago, it was 3,000 brand new. Of course I financed it. Right, there's that one. Got that one there. All right, time for the last three rows. What time is it? Oh, I'm good. If I can just get these last three rows laid out and pieced, all I absolutely have to get done to get the coldest pattern. All right, so I've got there. But of course, I'll run till 8 o'clock, and then hopefully you can start to see what it's going to look like. 1, 2, 3, 4, towards the black, towards the gold. Marley, honey, you can't be under the chair. I'm going to roll it. Okay, so that one's towards the gold, so it goes towards the blue. There. Okay. It's going to go towards the black. I love this gold. It is a Moda marble, and I just put an order in
for a ton of Moda marbles. Cannot wait to get them. Which one's the black? Let me reverse this then. I don't want to have to re-iron anything. Where's the black? Which one's the black? I think I am perfect. So these are the last, this is what is important, making sure that I have enough of all these pieces. So towards the blue, okay, no. I see what I did, I messed up down here. I only needed one. There, one of those. Okay. There, and I flipped it. See? Okay. Oh, you know what I did? I thought this was the middle one. Okay, so let me start this one all over. Alright, so there, towards, just that way. Okay, towards the black. Okay, towards black. Towards black. There we are. Then two. So. Okay. And then single. Single. There. Okay. Towards the gold. Towards the background. And there and there. There we go. All right, now that one's right. There. And double check, double check, double check. Okay, so there. Towards background, towards there. And I'm in this piece. And it should exactly run out of pieces at the end of this, towards the background. Unfortunately, this last row is the one that I have to re-iron a lot of pieces towards the black. Because as I've said numerous times, seam direction is important. Well, I must have cut an extra piece. Okay, here it is. Yes, it is this one. So, my brown, black, 898 with 310. Oh, you know what? I needed 9 of those pieces, I said. I bet I didn't pull out one when I cut 10. I didn't pull one out. Okay, so it is, it's good. It's perfect. Fantastic. I'm pretty happy. Okay, and then 1, 2, 3. Yep, we're good. Fantastic. Oh yeah. See you later, Doug. All right. Thanks for joining me. I appreciate it. super excited. I am almost done with these rows.
What time is it?
Oh, I still need to be able to put these. See, my goal is to try to get these rows put together for you. Now, I'm not going to have definitely have time to put the border on, but if I can get these rows put together, then you can get a sneak peek of what this new pattern is going to look like. The thing with pixel quilts is it's really hard to see what it's going to be until it's completely finished. Marley, no! Leave the cat alone. The joy of living with dogs. So I'm going to start sewing rows in between because I'm drawing my last three rows. So I'm going to sew the combined rows to just make it a little bit more efficient. And because I only have the three rows left, it's super easy to get them mixed up.
just ran into something else
that happens sometimes. It caught behind. So I've got to restitch this area here just to make sure that it catches. So that's gonna go right there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, I'm gonna need that one. Okay.
I was just checking my bobbin. That's another thing that I really like about the rubber machines is the drop-in bobbin is see-through to allow you to see exactly how much thread you have left in your bobbin.
Alright, so that is on the end there. I just have to double check to see. It's ironed this way. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the right. I love that seam ripper. So happy I found it. If you ever take classes from me, I may bring extras if you would like to buy one. They are fantastic, but you may be able to find them online too. It is the Seam Fix brand. Right. Alright, it is an odd number, but that's okay because the last one's bigger than the first piece. Mine was even. I didn't bother counting it though. So it looks like I only need one more pass through.
All right. My allergies are acting up. I don't know what it is, the winter time. My allergies just kill me.
I just did that, didn't I? I believe it's there. Okay. I know this one's right. And it is to the right. So just iron these two, since I know I mixed them up. Okay, all right, piece number two. Got to the left, got that one, and then this one, two, three, and then this one. And now last but not least, there. there, and there, and everything's to the right. Yes. Fantastic. I love it when I do not make mistakes. Everything lines up. And that is my rose. Okay, so these two. All right, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 rows of pinned things. And all the pins out of here. And I think what I'm going to do, I am not going to be able to have time to sew every single row together. So I am going to iron them all and lay them out. And that way you can see what my Black Mage is going to look like. I'm getting a little sneak peek into the next pattern. All right. So, next is this one. You may hear my dog barking upstairs. That is her insistence that she has to go outside. That way, and right. See, and this is the cool part, where you can see it all start to come together. Now, obviously, there's a little bit at the top. There is one row at the top that I don't have that finishes it off. It also, you notice, will end abruptly on the left and the right. That is because I add a border on after. So the way that my patterns work is that you create the pixelated image, and then you go through and add the borders. Right. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4 more rows down here where you can actually see the rest of the Black Mage for the very end and the bottom of the staff. So this is our new pattern that's coming out. We had at MAGFest, I had a couple requests for the Black Mage, so we worked really, really hard. And like I said, this wasn't supposed to be the next pattern. It was supposed to be the pattern after that. But we're having a small issue with the next pattern, but I want perfect before we actually put it out into production for you to buy it. So this is going to be the next one. Our goal is to get this done in the next couple of weeks. So I will be talking about it, and hopefully you'll see it pop up on social media. So thank you for joining me, everyone. I appreciate it. I will put this up on YouTube. So if you want to go back and watch anything that I talked about or watch the process from start to finish or any of that, you know, feel free to look it up on YouTube. I'm not going to edit anything out of it. Just going to go and put it up just like it is. So until I stream tomorrow, have a fantastic day. And hopefully my friend will join me tomorrow and we'll have a special guest. So thank you, everyone. Have a great day, and I will see you tomorrow.